In this session, we will explain one of the important concept in angle modulation, that is pre-emphasis and de-emphasis. So before to this, so the presence of noise is a major problem in the frequency modulation. So as whenever a strong interference signal, that is the noise signal, with a closed frequency to the desired signal that arrives. So at that time, the receiver locks that interference signal. Such a phenomenon is called as the capture effect. So to increase the signal to noise ratio at higher modulation frequencies. So a high pass circuit we are using a high pass circuit that is called pre-emphasis circuit. So this pre-emphasis circuit is used at the transmitter section. So nothing but, so the strong interference signal or strong noise signal is added at the closer frequency of the desired signal. So at that time, the receiver locks that interference signal. That effect is called as capture effect. So we can remove that noise. So at that time, we can increase the signal to noise ratio. So to increase the signal to noise ratio at higher modulation frequencies, so here we are using one circuit that is called as high pass circuit. That high pass circuit is called as a pre-emphasis circuit. So this pre-emphasis circuit are used at the transmitter section. And another circuit that is called de-emphasis, the inverse process of the pre-emphasis is used at the receiver, which is a low pass circuit. And we are using another circuit that is called de-emphasis circuit. So this de-emphasis circuit, the process is a reverse of this pre-emphasis. And this de-emphasis circuit is used at the receiver section. So the pre-emphasis and de-emphasis circuits are widely used in FM transmitter as well as the receiver. So to effectively increase the output signal to noise ratio. So the circuits, that is the pre-emphasis circuit and de-emphasis circuit, are worked at frequency modulator transmitter and the frequency modulator receiver. So the use of this pre-emphasis and de-emphasis circuits are to increase the output signal to noise ratio effectively. So that is the introduction about this pre-emphasis and de-emphasis circuits. So in frequency modulation, the noise has a greater effect on the higher modulating frequencies compared to the lower modulating frequencies. So this effect has a greater effect, nothing but, so the noise in frequency modulation is occurred at the effect of higher modulating frequencies. So this effect can be reduced by increasing the value of modulation index beta for higher modulating frequencies. Nothing but, so the noise has a greater effect, so to decrease or to reduce this effect, so we can increase the modulation index value, that is beta value, for higher modulating frequencies. So to this can be done by increasing the deviation del f, and can be increasing the amplitude of modulating signal at higher modulating frequencies. So thus, if higher frequencies were artificially boosted at the transmitter and similarly correspondingly cut at the receiver section, so an improvement in noise immunity could be expected, so thereby increasing the signal to noise ratio. So here, the boosting of higher modulating frequencies in accordance with a pre-arranged curve, that is called a pre-emphasis, and the compensation or decreases cut at the receiver section is called the de-emphasis circuit. So here the usage of microseconds for defining the emphasis is standard. So here the emphasis nothing but it is the standard, the units are microseconds. So the amount of pre-emphasis in US FM broadcasting has been standardized as 75 microseconds, whereas in European and Australian broadcasting it is 50 microseconds. So here we have seen the circuits of pre-emphasis circuits and the de-emphasis circuit. So these are the represented as the circuits of pre-emphasis and de-emphasis circuits. So here the modulating audio frequency signal, the input of this transistor is audio frequency signal. So the modulating audio frequency signal is passed through the low pass filter before applying to the FM modulator. Here is an FM increases, the reactance of capacitor C decreases. Here the FM increases, the reactance of C decreases, and modulating voltage applied to FM modulator goes to increasing, right? So that is if FM value is increases, then automatically the reactance of C decreases and modulating voltage, applied voltage to FM modulator goes to increasing. So the frequency response characteristics are shown in below. Here is the increasing, the boosting is done according to the pre-emphasis curve. So the amount of pre-emphasis in FM transmission or sound transmission in TV has been stabilized at 75 microseconds. So the pre-emphasis circuit is basically a high pass circuit. So the pre-emphasis is carried out at the transmitter. So the frequency for the RC high pass network is 2.122 Hz. So hence the pre-emphasis circuit is used at the transmitter section. This is about the pre-emphasis. And what is the de-emphasis? Nothing but, so the artificial boosting gives modulating frequencies in the process of pre-emphasis is nullified or compensated at the receiver by a process called de-emphasis. So the artificially boosted high frequency signal are brought to their original amplitude using the de-emphasis circuit. Nothing but it is a demodulation process. So the 75 microseconds de-emphasis circuit is standard and it is shown in the below figure. Here the figure shows that it is a low pass filter, that is 75 microseconds de-emphasis corresponds to a frequency response, that is 3 dB down at a frequency, so whose RC time constant is 75 microseconds. Here we are calculating the frequency, that is how to calculate this frequency. F is equals to 1 by 2 pi fc. So the demodulated FM applied to the differentiated circuit, so which is increasing FM, the reactance of C on both decreases. So here the frequency is increases, then automatically reactance of C decreasing and the output de-emphasis circuit will be reduced. So that is about the pre-emphasis and de-emphasis circuits. So here we are seen the frequency response characteristics of this both pre-emphasis and de-emphasis circuits. So here 0 dB to high pass circuit, that is the pre-emphasis circuit, and 0 dB to below 3 dB, that is represented as the de-emphasis circuits. So this is about the pre-emphasis and de-emphasis concept. Thank you.